The dawn is breaking, a light shining through. You're barely waking, and I'm tangled up in you.
Live, girl.
I worry I won't see your face.
There's too much estrogen in the room down there. Steve's starting to talk about lisp.
Now, mate. Oh my gosh, that isn't Steve.
Oh yeah.
Oh my god. Oh.
That fills my mind. Somehow find.
My phone won't come in down here.
Mine doesn't move. Sally, did you ever see in the bridal magazines the shot with the bride sitting on the bed and they got hardwood floors and the dress laying on the floor? You ever see shots like that?
No.
Well, this is reality. That's not the way it is.
Oh. This is reality.
This is the way it looks. There's 5,000 people out there to be watching.
I know.
They're all your friends and family. That's all you don't remember. Beautiful. Slide it this way. There we go. Do it again.
That's good. Hey, you don't want my poking out?
No, I'm gonna see the mirror. Go ahead, do it again.
Oh, you haven't?
Somehow find you and I.
This is here's to it, to those that do it. Those are close to it and don't do it's crazy. And then we have. Here's to you, here's to me. Hope to friends we should always be. If again we should never meet, here's to the we always
no blue jeans today.
Yeah, I see that.
Even the wrong words seem to rhyme. Out of the doubt that fills your mind, you finally find you and I collide.
Okay, I remember whenever I met you. You spent the entire night trying to pawn me off on your big girlfriend. A week later, you had to come to the bar that I worked at because you didn't remember what I looked like. And I think you were going to try to pawn me off on Sharon that night. But we ended up going out, having a good time. And then your birthday came up. I actually had plans for you to receive your ring on stage, called up by Kenny Chesney. But, you know, somebody eBayed the tickets. And Jack had a good laugh at me whenever, you know, he knew what was going on. And I call him up and say, well, you know, so much for that chance for a proposal because she's eBaying the tickets. And then there's the big fat zero that you're getting for your birthday that you almost left me over. And, you know, then there was those wonderful words of happiness whenever you got your ring. I think I'm going to be sick. But, you know, we've had our hard times. We've survived them, and you know, I think that this marriage is going to be a test of wills, and which one of us is going to will ourselves to live longer than the other. I love you, sweetie. Always will.
Well, you know, when we first met, I met this ugly son of
that I didn't even remember. He bought all my drinks, and the next day I got up, and, well, Chad, I had to call you and say, who the hell are you? And then I thought, well, what a stupid mother for trying to take my friend home. But turned out we went to Vegas for my 30th, remember? And I was at you. We fought the whole time. We had to sit in different seats. I cussed you like a dog and told you we were through. Then when we finally got to dinner, you still didn't give me a birthday present. Well, I still remember that, and finally, you gave me my ring. So yes, I was quite surprised. I was still a at you. But that kind of made the whole moment better. And here we are today, and I look forward to living the rest of my life with you. But you are a son of a, so just don't forget that. Am I done?